3:45.
Chapel. I have a few announcements this morning. Today is Youth Sunday, and there will be lunch in the fellowship hall after service. And Brother Jonathan Curtis is bringing the message. Next Saturday, March the 17th, is the Brotherhood Breakfast. There's a sign-up sheet in the foyer for anybody that's going to come. We really want you to sign it if you're planning on coming. Even if you don't, that'll be fine. The cooks need to be here at 4:30 to cook, and then we're eating at 6 o'clock. The next Sunday, March 18th, is the singing night. It'll just be Red Book hymnal singing. And then that Monday after that, March 19th, is the y'all lunch. It'll be cube steak and gravy plus the sides. And then April 1st is the Youth Easter program. The time will be announced. That's also Easter. Any other announcements?
Cullen, I need some more cooks for the y'all luncheon on Monday. Need a lot more vegetables. So y'all help us out.
Is that tomorrow?
We've been having a good crowd.
You said Monday. Is that tomorrow?
The 19th. Not tomorrow, Monday week.
Is there any other announcements? All right. Well, can I have anybody that has a birthday or anniversary come up?
Yeah.
Oh, she's, they're a year older.
pitch me.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you. May you have many, many more.
Now at this time, will everybody please stand and brother, get three of our youth to come up and
I'll
take a ball.
I don't know it, but I'll try.
Brother Johnny McClain, will you bless the offering?
I hope everybody loves the Lord this morning deep down in their heart. It's the name of this song, page 8. I thought it wasn't loud enough. One.
Can you hear me? There you go. We'd like to welcome each and every one of you. This morning we're fixing to go to the Lord in prayer. We always need to pray. And then after the prayer, we're going to turn young people loose. They have a program for us. It's going to take about 30 minutes. And if you're scared of the dark, grab somebody's hand, because it's going to get dark for a little bit. But it won't be dark long. But it is going to be dark. So, hang in there. Have a lot of faith. Trust in the Lord. Things will work out just right. Yes, they have. They've worked hard. I'd like to say that it is good to be here this morning. And let's remember the sick of our church. We have lots of them. We have people who are battling cancer. We have people who are just getting older and fighting the things that come with it. Now, I'm one of them. But, you know, I have somebody that can go with me and help me in my fight. Amen? And I don't ever want to let him get out of my heart and my life, because I'm going to need him from now on. And whether you realize it or not, you need him from now on. Amen? We all need God. So let's pray for those who do need our help and our prayers. My Bible teaches me that the prayers of a righteous person availeth much. Amen? So if you want to put your talent to use, pray. Amen? Who has a spoken request? And then we're going to go to the Lord in prayer and turn the kids loose. Remember Teddy. Let's remember Carol and Wayne and Stephanie and Robert. And we thank them for what they do. And we know it's been a battle, but we have a friend in Jesus. Amen. Remember that. Let's remember Roger. Let's call his name out. Go ahead, Tim. Amen. Let's remember that. Yeah, he gets mad, but I like making him mad, because you know who's helping us. We have somebody to help us in the fight. Anyone else? Go ahead, Tam, again. Anything else? Okay, let's go to the Lord in prayer.
I'm going to speak a little bit this morning before we get started. We're so proud of our youth. God is letting us grow, and it's such a blessing. It's such a blessing for me. We're going to ask that y'all use those fruits of the Spirit this morning. We're going to especially call on your patience, your kindness, and above all, your love. Wow, there's so much on my heart. I want to say God's put two people on my heart, but he put those two people in my heart also because of another person. You know, Mary Jo always good about sending us cards, and she's good about helping us. Jamie, we don't really need those curtains right yet because people may still need to go in and out. We're doing that 1 second. She's always good about sending cards, and she's good about encouraging all of us on Facebook, and it's such a delight to see. And I just want you to know that's contagious, and I thank you. And the Lord's put two people on my heart this morning to thank, and I know all of us do things, but he's just had these two on my heart, and so I just want to thank them. First of all, I want to thank you, Gary, for working here, and most of all, I want to thank you for your effective communication. You do it with humility, politeness, love, and encouragement, and I just want to say thank you for that. Yeah, give him a hand. And recently, I was talking to some new members about our setup with the projector and stuff, and when I got to telling them what all Robert does, you know, my hands just kept going. So I want to paint y'all a picture. I hope he doesn't get upset or embarrassed at me, but when Robert's up there, he is in charge of the projector. So he does the video for my dad. He does the scriptures. He does the announcements. Then you move on over to the soundboard, which has a million other responsibilities underneath it. And then you move over to the lights and the fan, and then he's recording the sermons and the youth. Then he takes that recording and he puts it on YouTube. Then he has the main computer, and he's also watching all of our security cameras to take care of us. So he's doing all those things simultaneously, and if you add them up, there's at least 8, and I'm sure there's more that I forget. And on top of that, it's at least 15 degrees hotter up in that nest than it is down here. And he can't turn on the air because it messes up the sound quality of the recording. So he tries his best not to turn that on. Then on top of that, he's probably 99% of the time worked the night before, hasn't got as much sleep as the rest of us, and he still comes in here to do his part, what he's called to do. So I just want to give Robert a big thank you, and I love you. So we're doing the first one. I want to skip to the second one. It is going to be dark. It's only for 4 minutes and 21 seconds. That's it. So during that time, we can't have anybody go outside either door, front or back, okay? And let's see. We also have some newcomers. They're battling some stage fright, so y'all pray for them. They're stepping out. And but I am proud of this group. You know, we as the youth leaders have seen fruit. We have seen the fruit of this ministry. We do activities with them, and we do make it fun, but we've seen the fruit. We've seen it in their prayer lives. We've seen it in their worship. We've seen it in their dedication. You know, Cullen, they won the state championship, and he's here for every practice. He goes to practice at school, and then he comes here for practice knowing he has schoolwork. And I know all of the others have basketball and baseball and band, and they all have different extracurricular activities. So we're so proud of them and thankful for them. So y'all give them a hand. All right. This first one that we're going to do is Come Alive. And there's several scriptures that could go with this video. The main one, of course, is going to be in Ezekiel 37. And Ezekiel is looking out across the valley of dry bones. And the Lord tells him to prophesy to these bones. And he also tells him to call on the four winds to breathe on these bones, and he would make them come to life. And he does. Bones come together, ligaments form, skin is put on them, and they come alive. And then a little bit further down, you hear this. Therefore, prophesy and say unto them, thus saith the Lord, behold, O my people, I will open up your graves and cause you to come up out of your graves and bring you into the land of Israel. So this song is come alive. And in this video, what you're going to see in this drama that we're doing, you're going to see this. Kennedy wanted to do this song, and Colin likes Black Eyes, so we try to listen to them too a little bit, because they're very important to us. And so some of them are going to be singing, then we're going to have the drama, but you're going to see some people in white and some people in black. The people you see in white, they believe in Jesus. They may come to church, but they just haven't given their all. They just haven't surrendered their life to Jesus. So they're going to come alive. And then we have those who haven't accepted Jesus as their Savior. And you're going to see these, when they come to life and get that spirit breathed on them, they witness and minister to those who don't know Jesus. And then they come to life. And then we all together take the word of the Lord out. And that's our goal, to bridge these generations so that our sphere of influence out in the world is greater, so that we can be greater witnesses for Jesus Christ and spread his gospel. So y'all come ahead, kids. Thank you.
while they're doing this. She said some newcomers that are stepping out and doing these things that, you know, they don't really like to do, being in front of people. I don't have a problem talking to people. I can talk to a brick wall, but I don't, you know, doing moves or trying to keep up with things. I'm not real coordinated. I can't sing. I used to sing, but I cannot sing. But when we're praising God, it doesn't matter. I just want to also thank Stacy. You know, she's been a big part of helping us learn these things and the kids learn these things. And she works night shift and comes sometimes to help us practice and coordinate all these things after she's been at work or got to go to work. And we don't give her enough thanks either, because I could not teach the kids these moves and these different things. I don't know how to do that. So I wanted to say, while they're getting all this together, that I wanted to thank her as well. And Stephanie, she kind of helps us. Stephanie, she kind of helps us keep everybody in line. That's her job as boss lady. And yeah, we call her the warden. And I want to thank her as well. You know, she has a lot on her plate, and she still tries to show up and help us with the kids. And then we have these men who are our workers that just do whatever the ladies tell them to, you know, so that's important. It takes a group effort. I always heard people say it takes a village to raise a child. Well, that's true. And I'm so thankful for our village and all of you. And I hope y'all get a blessing out of this as much as I have with watching these kids and participating with them.
Spirit, and He's given us life. We know we've been long today, and we've had a lot to say, but Amanda gave a testimony Sunday night, and I thought a lot about that this week. And the Lord laid it on her heart, you know, about, you know, we kind of grew up here, and we've learned from everybody, you know, learned how to, you know, I guess the ropes and worship and, you know, but most of all, we praise Jesus. But with that saying, we talked about, you know, things we learned in classrooms and everything, but, you know, we also learned a lot by singing. For years, we've watched Paul and Ronnie, you know, lead us and guide us and sing to us, and so it was laid on my heart to do what's called an old-fashioned hoedown. So if Paul and Ronnie, if y'all want to make your way up here and get behind these kids on the microphone, we got a little surprise for you. Gary, if you want to help us, because you heard us practice, and anybody who'd like to sing, but I hope y'all get some enjoyment out of this. This church has been around since 1919. This next year is our 100-year anniversary, or birthday, I guess you'd say. I think that's going to be a grand celebration, unless our Lord comes back and gets us before.
Did you say we'd been around since 1919?
No, I didn't say you'd been around that long. I said you've been, our church has. But my roots run deep here. I love this place. I love everybody in it. But, you know, I want to bridge old and young here. I want to see a church united, because a church united could grow, but one divided can't. It takes old, young, from top to bottom. I'm not good with words about trying to relay what I get across, but I love everybody. I hope you're blessed. I hope you get blessed from these kids, because it's a blessing working with them. And y'all just bear with us, because I threw this on Clay and Stacy, and I said, we got to roll. And when I say we got to roll, they're like, okay, we're going to roll. So I hope y'all are blessed. I hope y'all been blessed today. And I'm thankful to Amanda and Stacy and Robert and Clay and Jamie, everybody who helps here, and people who cook when we need them to cook, to provide, and we're feeding them. And I'm just thankful. And I love every one of y'all from the bottom of my heart.
This is where music started. This is the grassroots of gospel music, right?
Yeah.
This song is it's really a medley. You guys know the words to these songs. I know you do. And we're going to need help. Clap them hands, stomp them feet, get up and help us sing these songs, okay? You ready with me?
House of the Lord this morning. Can anybody say it hasn't been good to be in the house of the Lord this morning?
It's been great.
It's been good. Yes. Ain't nobody said it's been bad, so that's a good sign. I want to say this morning before we get started, get into the message any further. I do appreciate what has just happened. The word of the Lord has been shown this morning. I'm not going to say a whole lot, but I do want to say this, I appreciate what I saw. It was good. The Spirit was in it. It was truth this morning. I believe this morning. Question, do you believe?
I believe, yes. Amen.
Do you believe this morning that Jesus Christ came into this world, bled and died for your sins, and rose again the third day, victorious over death, hell, and the grave?
Yes.
Do you believe this morning? If you don't believe this morning, I pray that you come to that knowledge of that truth this day. If it could be God's will, and I believe it could be. And know Him as your personal Lord and Savior this morning. Without faith, it is impossible to please Him that has called us this morning. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. I hope and pray this morning that you have your Bibles with us. Very familiar scripture. Turn with us to the book of Luke, chapter number 7. Luke chapter number 7. I want to look into this passage of scripture this morning. I've prayed, Brother Sam, for 2 weeks since I got the call. I don't know exactly how long it's been that the Lord's will would be done here this morning. And I trust and pray that that will happen. If He has to move me plumb out of the way, use somebody else to get His will done, that's fine with me. But I hope and pray this morning that His will be done in whatever's done and accomplished this morning, that He might get the praise, the honor, and the glory out of it this morning. I'm certainly nothing, and He can certainly choose to use anybody or anything that He wants to get His honor and glory. But I'm thankful this morning that He chose me to be His child one day, that He chose me to come and to worship and to serve Him. And He also looked down through the ages of time, and He saw the need for a man to stand and preach the Word of God. And I don't know why He chose me, but He chose me. And I know that as sure as I know salvation's real today. I know that from the depths of my soul. I would like to get away from it many a times, but I cannot get away from the Word of God today. It's got me. As Paul said, I have tried to apprehend that which has already apprehended me. The Word of God has got me, and I don't know what to do but give it to you this morning. So if you have your Bibles, turn with us and help us and pray with us this morning. The book of Luke, the 7th chapter and the 11th verse, we'll begin reading. And it came to pass the day after that He went into a city called Nain. And many of His disciples went with Him, and much people. Now, when He came nigh to the gate of the city, behold, there was a dead man carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And much people of the city was with her. And when the Lord saw her, and He had compassion on her, and said unto her, weep not. And He came and touched the bed, and they that bare Him stood still. And he said, young man, I say unto thee, arise. And he that was dead sat up and began to speak. And He delivered him to his mother. And there came a fear on all they. And there came a fear on all. And they glorified God, saying that a great prophet is risen up among us, and that God has visited His people. Now this rumor of Him went forth throughout all Judea, and throughout all the regions round about. And the disciples of John showed Him all these things. And John called unto Him two of His disciples, saying, sent them to Jesus, saying, art thou He that should come, or look we for another? And when the men were came unto Him, they said, John Baptist hath sent us unto thee, saying, art thou He that should come, or look we for another? And in that same hour He cured many of their infirmities, and plagues, and of evil spirits, and unto many that were blind He gave sight. And Jesus saith unto them, go your way, and tell John what things ye have seen and heard, how that the blind see, and that the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have the gospel preached. And to the poor the gospel is preached. Sorry about that. And blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we do humbly come before you one more time, God, we ask you, Lord, as we come this way one more time, Lord, I pray, Lord, that you'd search the depths of our souls, Lord, if there's anything. Oh Lord, one more time, I ask you, oh Lord, that it be displeasing in my life. God, I pray for forgiveness, for removal of it. God, we realize that you cannot, and Lord, you will not hear us if we regard iniquity, oh Lord, within our hearts. And Lord, we realize this morning that we're a very needy creature this morning, that we're very imperfect.
Oh, Lord, that we stumble and stagger throughout life. And, Lord, I ask you, oh, to just forgive us and, Lord, to help us to walk a straight and narrow way this morning. Oh, God, I ask you, Lord, this morning as we look into this scripture, oh, Lord, as the songs has went forth throughout everything, oh, Lord, that you would call unto your people today one more time. Oh, God, I ask you, Lord, to forgive us where we failed you. Take us, use us, and cleanse us, Lord. Give us an unction from on high, oh, Lord, that only you can. Lord, we love you. We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
The thought that's been on my heart this morning is to ask you this morning, is Jesus it, or do you look for another? Amen. I want you to think about this morning. Is Jesus you're all in all this morning? As we look into this passage of Scripture, we see a little glimpse in throughout this Scripture of what Jesus has done and what Jesus can do. I want you to know this morning that everything that He has done, He can do and He will do this morning. I want you to know that the same Jesus that walked up and down the avenues and up and down the streets of Jerusalem can walk up and down the avenues of your soul this morning. I want you to know that He's a very present help in the time of need this morning. I want you to know this morning that He is sufficient this morning. They was going through the drama and that lined up with the Scripture this morning, so many things about Jesus and the cross and what He's done for us this morning. I want you to know this morning that He has defeated death, hell, and the grave this morning. We look into this passage of Scripture this morning. I want you to stop and take notice that Jesus was on a journey. He was traveling somewhere. He had went from one place. He was going unto another. And as He came into the city of that place, the Bible said that this young man was being carried out on his bed, on his stretcher. The Bible definition gives an open coffin, you might say. But he was being carried out for a burial. I want you to know this morning that you may feel like that young man today. You may feel like life is hopeless. He was being carried out from his hometown. He had left out of this world and was going to another. You may feel that way this morning. You may feel like there's no hope. This mother, no doubt, going along heartbroken. We realize this morning of the state and condition in which she was in, being a widow and not her only son. She didn't have any family, close family to take care of her. That's a serious thing. People take for granted the blessings and the family and the fellowship that we have in the land of America. And I want you to know this morning, until you get without it, you won't truly understand it. Not to mention, it was her son that had lost his life. The Bible said that Jesus saw her and He moved with compassion. He had compassion upon her. I want you to know this morning that if you're like this man, if you're dead in your trespasses and sin, Jesus has already moved with compassion towards you this morning. He done that on the cross of Calvary. I want to back up and say He done that in the foundation of the world. The Bible said that it was predetermined in the foundations of the world that He was to be the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. The Bible said He was already predestined for a place on Calvary on a rugged cross for your and our sins this morning, and not only for our sins, but I want you to know this morning, but it's here for the Bible said that by His stripes we are healed this morning. I believe there's more than just a little spiritual healing. I still believe in it this morning. I do believe that this morning. But I do know about a spiritual healing. I've been blessed to have good physical strength in this body. Believe me, I've got my aches and pains some mornings. Haven't been to the doctor in who knows when. Since I was a little kid, probably the most strong medicine I've took in 15 years has been an aspirin. But I want you to know, I may not know that much about doctrinal healing. I know about a spiritual healing.
Amen.
This old flesh don't matter much. It's the temple of God, I know. We're to treat it that way. We're to clothe it that way. We're to nurture it that way. We're to take care of it. But what matters is what that dwells in the temple.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
There's something was inside of me that was dead in trespasses and in sin, and I had no hope within myself. The Bible said that Paul wrote to him over there in one place and said, remember how that you were dead in trespasses and sin, how that you were alienated from God, from the commonwealth of Israel, without God and without hope in this world. I want you to know this morning that if you don't find Jesus Christ, if you don't find salvation, you are without hope in this life and in the life to come. I want you to know this morning that you can hook and crook and do whatever you want to climb up the ladder of success. But when you get there, I want you to know that you still haven't got nothing, because the Bible said that the elements of this earth is going to melt with a fervent heat this morning. And the Bible said that our works are going to be tried with fire this morning. I don't know why we're going down this road this morning, but if that's where Jesus wants to go, I'm good to go this morning. I want you to know that our works are going to be tried with a fervent heat this morning. And the Bible said, for those that are burnt up, He said, we're going to suffer loss, my friends. For those that remain, then we'll be accounted for. I want you to know this morning that the Bible says that my works are as filthy rags, a stinking an abomination in the sight of God this morning. I want you to know that I in myself cannot do anything that will profit me in this life with Jesus Christ or the life to come. Amen? Or the life to come. I still believe in that. I believe there's going to be a resurrection one day. And I believe I'm on the trip. Amen. I don't know about you. I can't tell you your heart. That's between you and Jesus. I had to get a one-on-one with Him as well. But this man was going to a place of darkness. He had done left. Hey man, I want you to know this morning, he had done left and was headed. He was gone. He was in wherever he was. The Bible said, as a tree falls, so shall it lie. I don't know where he was going. The Bible don't record, but he is there. Paul said to be absent from the body is present with the Lord. Amen. This man was there. I don't know why, but the Lord said, wait a minute, son. Your mama still needs you, amen? Now I want to go somewhere with that, hallelujah. I don't know why God wants that, but I want you to know this morning, if you're sitting here lost, your mama still needs you. I don't know if you know who your mama is this morning. I'll back up and make sure of that. The church is my spiritual mother this morning. I want you to know this morning, every one of you sitting here this morning, your mama needs you. I've heard that before. Daddy said, hey son, your mama needs you. I'm trying to put it in perspective this morning. God needs us. He don't have to have us, but He desires us this morning. Why? Because He loves us. Amen. He can do without us, I'll assure you. He stepped onto nothing and created everything. He is God this morning. He created us, I'm sure. He done without us in the past. But He loves us because we were created in His image and in His likeness. I want you to know this morning that God loves you. God desires you. though he may not love some things about your life. Heard some preaching over the last few weeks and a lot of studying and thinking about some men talking about a lot of the New Age church and generation that's going on. And a lot of the preaching, though, I want you to know God loves you this morning, that God is love. But God don't send the sin to hell, but the sinner this morning. If God loves you, and then if you're so good and God is so proud that you turned out the way you are in your sinful state, why did Jesus come die? And if you in yourself could be justified, why did Jesus come die? I'll tell you why. Because you could not by yourself, and you could not by any means. You are part of a fallen generation that must be born again. You must be born again to see the kingdom of heaven. But Jesus spoke. Has He spoke to your life before? I want to ask you this question from young to old. Has Jesus ever spoke to you? Has Jesus ever spoke to you? Through the preached Word of God? Through song? Spiritual song? Songs are wonderful. They ain't going to get you to heaven. That's scriptural. I don't want to get into that this morning, but that's scriptural. But I tell you what's going to get you there. It ain't going to be mom and daddy's coattail, granny and grandpa's religion, or the church down the street. But it's going to be a personal relationship with Jesus Christ this morning. It's going to take a call from heaven, from Jesus, to come unto me, all ye that are weary and heavy laden, that I may give you rest this morning. This man was on his way out, and Jesus said, whoa, wait a minute. I remember that woe in my life. I don't know about you, but I'm praying Jesus will call out to you if you are here in trespasses and sin, and says, wait a minute, I've got a better plan for you this morning. I want you to know this morning that you don't have to go and look any further. This morning it's in Jesus Christ. Whatever you need. Young man, I say unto you, arise. What did he do over at the tomb of Lazarus? He said, Lazarus. He called him by name. No doubt Jesus probably knew this young man's name because he's an all-knowing God. But him being the fleshly man that he was, he probably didn't know this young man's name. But he said, young man, arise this morning. He called out to what? Some dead, dry bones to come alive. Amen?
Amen.
That's what he done. And I believe the Holy Spirit of God swept right down and he touched that young man that day. And he become alive. I want you to know today that if you come and surrender your heart and your life to Jesus, and whether you want to admit it or not, all the emptiness and deadness that's in your life, you can become bubbly again.
Amen.
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 Does anybody here like to be bubbly?
Amen.
Amen. Just always a good attitude. Amen. I do. Though I seem serious all the time, probably to most people, I love to be bubbly with Jesus. If you ain't been bubbly, and if you can't be bubbly in Jesus, I want you to know Jesus can make you bubbly.
Amen.
Amen. He can make you happy with a joy that is beyond anything this world can ever offer. It can offer you some wonderful things. The Bible clearly says that the pleasure of sin, there's pleasure in it, but it will only last for a season. I've been down that road. I know about it. I've walked through some of those fun times, per se. Well, I had a blast until I turned around and faced myself and who I really was. And I couldn't stand it. Why? Because I knew God had created me for a greater purpose. And it's to give honor and glory and praise unto His name. And also, I knew that the man that I had become was a man full of sin and sorrow and headed to a place of destruction. And I had to take a choice one day. My choice. As Joshua said, choose you this day whom you'll serve. Amen. But as for me and my house, I'm going to serve the Lord. Amen. Have you made that choice this morning? Whether you're lost, whether you're saved, maybe you're not where you need to be. Maybe you'd like to kick that shoe off. Amen. Amen. It'll be all right. I want it to go out the back door. Why? Because I want to get on holy ground this morning. Praise Jesus. You can be saved if you get on your knees with God this morning. Hallelujah. There's power in prayer. Praise Jesus this morning. You on a show this morning, but I want you to know that there's power in the name of Jesus this morning. I want you to know that if you will make a choice this morning, that I am going to surrender my life and my all in all with Jesus Christ. I'm going to repent of my sins, turn from the wickedness that I'm in and the emptiness and all those things that the devil's promised me, that I can have life and have it more abundantly.
Amen.
I don't reckon I got a hole in my sock. If I do, that'll be all right. It might be, brother. I'd sell them a many a good wore out pair for $60 myself. Mama always patched them or I threw them away. Lord, give me clothing to cover up my nakedness. I don't know why they want to wear it no more. It still don't cover it up. That's another message for another day. I'm being honest. Are you going to make a choice to serve Christ? It's part of it. Amen. He said, come ye out from among the world and choose you the Lord. Amen. Put away the strange gods that are before, that are among you. Amen. And turn to Jesus Christ. John the Baptist had heard of all these great things. He had baptized John, but he's sitting in prison. Amen. He's under some persecution. Things has got a little rough in his life. And he's saying, Lord, is this really you? I need some deliverance. I want you to know this morning that deliverance comes in many ways. I believe John the Baptist is in heaven today. He lost his head to get there. You know what? I'll lose my head if that's what it takes to have Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I'll lose my head if that's what it takes to lose Jesus. Most even say, well, brother, I think you done lost it. I'm not trying to be funny, but the world thinks that today. If that's what it's all about, then preacher, I don't want none of it. You get a little bit of what I got and you want some of it.
Amen.
Amen. I want you to know this morning that there is a foundation that you can set your feet on that is not shaky this morning. It is a rock solid foundation, and it's faith alone in Christ alone for your sin. Amen. In it alone this morning. It's faith alone in Christ alone, amen, for all my needs, amen. I think you want you to know this morning that He is sufficient. He's John the Baptist said, are you the Christ or do we look for another this morning? Let's back up and see what this John Jesus said over here.
So look down at this just a minute. He said, go your way and tell John what things ye have seen and heard. Amen. How that the blind see. Amen. If you're here and you're blind spiritually, he can cause you to see. I believe this book is spiritually written and it'll be spiritually discerned. If you can't understand it, come to Jesus. He will give you an understanding this morning. Church, if you want to know what it's going to take to get your church to grow and to see people saved, and I believe you've been there, but go to Jesus. I want to keep you encouraged this morning. Stay with Jesus. Stay with Jesus. And stay with the real Jesus this morning. There's been many Jesuses being preached today, and they're not all the Jesus of Nazareth that hung on a cross either. Stay with Jesus, the God of the Bible, this morning. Stay with it. It's got us this far, and it will carry us the rest of the way. I believe when Christ said it's finished on the cross of Calvary, I believe everything necessary for the plan of salvation was completed, my friend. And I believe it's complete in Him. Show John what thing you see, how that the blind see, the lame walk. Amen. Satan will cripple you up. There's a lot of people today sitting in home, the nursing homes, hospitals, because of depression over sin. Do you know worrying was a sin? What is worry? It's a lack of faith. It's a lack of faith. The lame walk. The leper's cleansed. If you're here and you're spotted up with sin, what that represents, He'll clean you up. Let me tell you, this old boy wasn't spotted with a little leprosy. He had a few spots. Still skin showing. There was just a few traits of a human being left in me. The rest of me was sin. Whether I want to admit that or not, that's the sad truth. If you stood my life up before me, that's who I'd say that's in that mirror. That may be who you are today. Jesus can clean you up. The lepers are cleansed. The deaf hear. If you're here and you haven't heard God speak, maybe God hasn't called you yet. I believe you must be called to be saved. I believe that. You aren't going to get up some morning and say, I think I'm just going to get saved today. I believe you're going to come when Christ calls. These little prayers that they say repeat all the time, I repeated a bunch of them. To myself. Didn't make me no more saved than the man on the moon from dying of lack of oxygen. The only thing was God hadn't cut the cord yet. You cut that man's oxygen hose off up there, he's going to die. The only difference between me and that man was God hadn't cut the cord off. The lepers are cleansed, the deaf hear, the dead are raised. Hallelujah. I want you to know this morning that He will take you in your dead state. Discouragement, depression, sin, whatever it is. If you'll come to Him and give Him your life, He will raise you up. He said, humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that He may exalt you in due time. He said, to this man will I look, to him that is of a broken heart. and a contrite spirit. He said, he that cometh to me with a broken heart and a contrite spirit, he said, I will in no wise cast him out. I want you to understand that this morning, that if you'll come to him as honestly and humbly and as broken as you can, he will hear your cry. Give him your all in all this morning. The dead are raised, to the poor the gospel is preached. I want you to know this morning, if you're poor and broken in spirit, the gospel can be preached to you through Jesus Christ. If you've been here this morning and you're downtrodden, and you're depressed, and you're poorly in spirit, the gospel this morning, I believe it's here among us. I believe Jesus has walked among us this morning. The gospel is preached. It said, and blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me. Are you offended in Jesus Christ this morning? The gospel, it offended me for a long time. It did. It offended me. People are worried about getting offended nowadays, offending somebody. I'm not here to hurt your feelings. I'm here to tell you the truth because I love you. And if the truth hurts your feelings, I want you to know Jesus said, I am the truth, the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. He said, and if the truth has made you free, you are free indeed. There's nothing else. There's no power on this earth. There's no power in heaven. There's no power in hell that can ever bind you down. Amen. If the truth of Jesus Christ has come into your heart and into your life, and you've accepted it and you've believed it and it's changed your life, you've been born again, there is nothing that can bind you down. You are set free indeed, my friend. There's no sin that you must stumble over. Amen. You can step on it. Amen. Would you come to Jesus this morning if He's called you? You've probably heard the call many times. I want to ask you this one question. All the good spirit, the singing, the truth. I don't know. You might have had your hand up in the cross. You may have. I don't know. But if you're here and you're lost this morning and you haven't been born again, washed in the blood of the Lamb, if there's a question mark, am I going to heaven? Good chances are you ain't. I'm being honest because I love you. The day that I finally got it, the 2 years that I run that I thought I had it, all those question marks, they got triumphed, they got walked on, they got left behind by the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Why? Because I know that I've been saved. You can know this morning. You can know. If there's doubt in your life, would you come? Would you come and ask Jesus? I went to Him many times and said, Lord, what is the truth about me? What is the truth about me? Am I really your child? Why? Because I didn't know. I want you to know you can know today. I'm going to ask you this one question. If Jesus calls you today, would you answer? Would you answer? Would you answer? If Jesus looks down and sees you, and He sees your condition, and He wants to help you, and He calls out to you, would you surrender and submit yourself and let God help you this morning? Let God save you. Would you do that? Would you humble yourself? Let go of the pride. Say, I've got it myself. Just let go of that. I don't know, church, what you might be needing. There may be something in somebody's life here you just don't know what to do with.
If God calls you to come and pray and ask Him and seek with Him, would you just let go and say, come and say, I trust you with it? Would you do that this morning? That's the question. If Jesus calls, would you answer? I don't know your heart. All I know is what God put on mine. And I've done the best that I know how, the least that I am, to try to honor and glorify Him and deliver to Him what He has delivered to me. Would you come this morning? Someone comes and gets a song of invitation this morning. The altar's open. Would you come? Would you come? Stand with us, please. Stand with us. Believe it or not, this old barefoot preacher would love to pray with you.
Amen.
I'd love to get on holy ground with you.
Amen.
Why? Because I want to see you walk the streets of gold with me. I want to see you shout around the throne, hallelujah, praises to the King. But if He calls, will you answer this morning? Will you submit yourself unto Him? I don't know your need, I don't know your heart, but before you go out that door, would you come to the door this morning? I'm the Lord, church. Would you come? Will Sam come stand with us, please? This altar's open. I hope it's never been closed. Would you come?
When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. For I am yours, and you are mine. Oh, and you are mine. Oh,
question this morning, Lord put on my heart. If you could buy heaven, what would you pay? What would you pay for heaven? If you could take what you got and what you own and could buy heaven of it, what portion of it would you give Him for an exchange for heaven? I want you to know this morning that you cannot buy heaven with anything on this earth except you. Church, you can't touch heaven except how? By you. You've got to sell out to Jesus. You might say, preacher, that's a great price my entire life. Let me tell you something. Your life is going to be much better with Jesus than without it. You might think it's terrible to just have to give your life up for Jesus. Preacher, I love my life. I just love the way it is. There's a day coming that you're not. Reality will set in one day. Maybe you're here and you're lost. Maybe you're here and you're not. Maybe you've just never totally sold out to Jesus. I want you to consider this morning. What would you pray for? The Bible asks this question, what would a man give in exchange for his soul? To know that you have a home in heaven, that you've been born again, what would you give this morning? I tell you what I had to pay. I gave it all to Jesus, and He gave me all of heaven. Amen. And He sent me a great portion of it on earth. He said, I will let you sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. I've been there. A lot of us this morning, I'm afraid there's somebody here that's a lot like this. We kicked the world off and threw them out the door a while ago, didn't we? Right here's about what most of y'all are going to do, or some of you. See that? You just shook it off one more time. And you're probably going to walk right out that door just in the shape that you come in. What went you out, come you out for to see this morning? What did you get up out of bed and come to church for this morning? I did, to get help from the Lord. Believe it or not, I get help helping others. If you come and help Jesus this morning, He will help you this morning. Before you pull the shoes of the world right back on and go back out into the world and blend in with the rest of them, won't you try kicking them off and staying with Jesus this morning? Paul, I hate to ask you this morning, but y'all going to have to give that one more verse of the song. I was going to let you walk right out that door, but I can't do it. I don't know who stands in need this morning. This verse is for you. This opportunity of mercy is for you. I say that with brokenness this morning because I've stood there and I know what just a few moments, one verse of a song
the difference that it made in my life. It can make in yours if you'll just come to Jesus this morning. If you would just step out and let go of the world.
I've had choices.
You've got a choice to make.
Since the day that I was born.
Come to Jesus.
I've heard voices.
Just as you are. Sinner, lost and undone.
Told me right from
wrong. Leave a child of the King this morning.
To listen.
Would you come?
That's why I'm in church today. I'm living and dying with the choices I've made.
You've been given an opportunity to make a choice that'll make a difference
I
in your
was
life. Would you
tempted.
Come? Would you come?
At an early
age,
I
found
I like drinking.
Would you come?
And I never turned it down. There were loved ones that turned and walked away. I'm living and dying with the choices I made.
Would you come?
Yes, I'm paying for the thing that I have done. I could go back. Lord knows I'd run, 'cause I've been losing this game of life I've played. I'm living with the choices I made. You'll have choices since the day that you were born. You'll hear voices that'll tell you right from wrong. You'll just listen. You'll be in church today. You'll live and you'll die by the choices you made. I've had choices since the day that I was born. I've heard voices. Told me right from wrong. Yes, I listen. That's why I'm in church today. I'm living and dying with the choices I made. You'll live and you'll die by the choices you made.
We thank you for your kind attention. We do have a bill in the back if you'll stay after.